Good evening, parents, family members, staff, anyone else watching out there, and most certainly graduating students. We are very happy to welcome you tonight in this graduation celebration. As we wind down in the final days of another very difficult and different school year, we realize how fortunate we are that although this celebration looks much different than any of us would hope for, we are still able to gather as a school community virtually to celebrate this exceptional group of graduates. What a pleasure it has been to teach these kids, both in class and virtually. This is a very special evening for our young people. It is the culmination of 10 years of laughter, learning, hard work, and perhaps a few disappointments and tears as they navigated the course through elementary school. Our celebration tonight signifies the closing of one chapter in the lives of our graduates. Yet as one chapter closes, the next one will soon begin. We are hopeful for them as we all ponder what the future may hold. Ladies and gentlemen, without further delay, please join me in welcoming the St. Patrick's graduating class of 2021.
Haley Adams. Thelma Boehm. Abby Balduke. Addison Braun.
Denham Bronson.
J.J. Cagbe. Taylor Kennard. Landon Chase. Emily Clifford. Natalia Collette. Elijah Camiso. Dominic Crandall. Kaylee Davey. Gavin DeBuscher. Dominic DeJong. Nora Lynn Edlund. Evan Farkas. Jaden Folletti. Everett Force. Caitlin Gardner. Christopher Goss. Lincoln Graham. Devontae Guevara Barrett. Jezreel Jinko. Avon Andres Lagos. Christopher Lale. Christopher Lale. Phoenix McMahon. Keelan Murphy. Ava Newton. Gabby Orzechowski. Aaron Owusu-Mensah. Carter Skevington. Vianna Summers. Vontae Thompson. Enoch Teppo. Lucas Edding. Kali Van Weinsberg. Lauren Warnock. Tess Ann Williams. Lily Wojcicki. Madison Young. Madison Young. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with great pleasure that I present to you the graduating class of St. Patrick's of 2021.
Haley Adams rejoins us for graduation this evening after participating in remote learning for her full grade 8 year. Prior to this, Haley was with us at St. Patrick's from grade 1 to grade 7. Haley's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when she first came to St. Pat's in grade 1, and she remembers being so nervous and excited, but the staff and students were also supportive and caring. Haley will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where she is hoping to make some friends, get good grades, and make her mom proud. In 10 years, Haley hopes to have graduated college or university in the field of ultrasound technician, as she loves, and is very interested in that. Haley also hopes she can travel all around the world, especially Greece and Egypt. Haley hopes she will have built her self-confidence and work ethic. Thelma Bohem has been at St. Patrick's since grade 6. Thelma's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when she got to practice and run track. Thelma will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where she is planning to prepare toward working as a nurse and help those in need. In 10 years, Thelma will still be living in peace with a good job, putting God first, and living with a beautiful family that is probably chilling in Japan. This year, Thelma achieved an academic average of 80% or higher, which makes her a member of the honor roll. Congratulations, Thelma. Thelma is also being awarded as this year's winner of the Artistic Contribution Award. Thelma possesses tremendous visual art skills and also demonstrates proficiency in music and drama. We're going to miss admiring your amazing art pieces, Thelma. Congratulations. Abby Ball Duke has been at St. Patrick's since kindergarten 2011. Abby's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is the bus trip to medieval times in grade 5. Abby will be attending high school at Cass, where she is hoping to actually graduate grade 12. She is excited to make new friends. She is planning to do her best next year. In 10 years, Abby hopes to be in New York, owning a little apartment with her friends or significant other. Her dream is to work on drag cars or even race them one day. Her plans for 10 years from now is to have a good paying job.
Addison Braun has been at St. Patrick's for many years. Her favorite memory is hanging out with Lauren and their friends. Addison hopes to finish her education, and in 10 years, she wishes to be happy and successful.
Denham Brotzel came to St. Patrick's in grade 1. Denham's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he made his first friend back in grade 1. Denham will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is planning to finish grade 12 and go on to college as well. In 10 years, Denham hopes to have finished high school, and he also hopes to have moved on to college. He hopes to be enrolled in college, and he really wants to be able to study in architecture, which is a dream career of his. This year, Denham has successfully achieved an academic average of 80% or higher, which makes him a member of the honor roll. Way to go, Denham. John Cackbay, aka JJ, has been at St. Patrick's since grade 3. John's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he went to Bowler Mountain for a field trip. John will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is hoping to make new friends, join the basketball team, and succeed. In 10 years, John hopes to finish college or university, get a good job, and travel the world, primarily to Japan. This year, JJ achieved an academic average of 80% or higher as well, which makes him a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. It is my honor to also recognize JJ as this year's winner of the Male Athlete of the Year Award. JJ is a complete athlete, combining exceptional skills, dedication, and sportsmanship. He is a team player who effectively and quietly leads by example. Although we didn't have any teams, unfortunately, this year, this was always evident in all of our outdoor activities. Congratulations, John. JJ. Okay, Taylor Kennard is the newest member of our graduating class, having just came to us this year for grade 8 after having moved from Alberta. Taylor's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when she met Ava and Kaylee. Taylor will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where she is hoping to get amazing grades. In 10 years, Taylor hopes to have her own hair and nails business. This evening, Taylor is also being recognized for having achieved an academic average of 80% or higher, making her a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. Congratulations, Taylor. Landon Chase has been at St. Patrick's since grade 2. Landon's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he met his friends. Landon will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is hoping to learn what he needs to succeed. In 10 years, Landon hopes to have graduated RMC as an officer specializing in electrical or mechanical engineering. Landon achieved an academic average of 80% or higher this year, which makes him a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. In addition to this, Landon is being recognized this evening as a co-recipient of the Principal's Award of Excellence. The Principal's Award of Excellence is awarded to the student or students who achieve the highest overall academic average. Their hard work, determination, and dedication to academics is always admired and will serve you well in the future. Emily Clifford has been at St. Patrick's since junior kindergarten, left in grade 6, and came back for grade 8. Emily's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is of her friends and being a part of their growth and becoming who they are. Emily will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where they're expecting to start a streaming career on Twitch. In 10 years, Emily hopes to be happily out of the closet and to be having a wonderful career in content creating and running a small business. Natalia Collette has been at St. Patrick's for all of elementary school. Natalia's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when in grade 6, her class went to treetops at Boulder Mountain. Natalia will be attending high school at Cass, where she is planning to continue in a career of arts. In 10 years, Natalia hopes to be working in an industry of animation and/or working with any sort of arts.
Elijah Camiso has been at St. Patrick's since senior kindergarten. His favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he used to play dodgeball with Mr. Mack. Eli will be attending high school at St. Mary's Catholic High School, where he is hoping to finish, go to university, and be successful. In 10 years, Elijah hopes to have a job that pays good money, but his childhood dream will always be to become a professional athlete.
Dominic Crandall has been at St. Patrick's since the start of elementary school and has never switched schools. Dominic's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he went to Boulder Mountain for his field trip in grade 6, where he climbed trees and ziplined with his friends. Dominic will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is hoping to join lots of clubs and is planning to be successful in his grades. In 10 years, Dominic has the hopes that he has traveled some and is working as a firefighter saving lives. Kaylee Davey has been at St. Patrick's since kindergarten. Kaylee's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when she got to help the grade fives with track and field. Kaylee will be attending high school at WCI, where she is hoping to finish all grades with an honor roll. In 10 years, Kaylee plans on becoming an author and releasing a book, along with having a family. Kaylee has achieved an academic average of 80% or higher, which makes her a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. Her academic achievement this year, combined with her determined work ethic and growth and maturation as a student and person, have also led her to being chosen as the Most Improved Student Award. And just wait, there's one more. Kaylee has also been recognized by staff as the graduating student most deserving of the Helen Parent Kindness Award. The Helen Parent Award is a memorial award recognizing the student who demonstrates consistent dedication and care for others in the school community. Kaylee is always respectful, polite, kind, and compassionate. She is always willing to lend a helping hand to staff and students and be a good friend to others in the school. Congratulations on being presented with these outstanding achievements, Kaylee. Gavin DeBuscher has been at St. Patrick's since kindergarten. Gavin's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he was Slinky in the Toy Story dance. Gavin will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is hoping to meet new friends. In 10 years, Gavin hopes to see his friends. Dominic DeJong has been at St. Patrick's since fourth grade, coming from Brantford, Ontario. Dominic's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is playing dodgeball. Dominic will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he's excited to finish high school and spend time with his family. In 10 years, Dominic will graduate and do tech on computers, phones, and consoles. Coraline Edlin was at St. Patrick's from kindergarten to grade 1, and then came back for grades 4 to 8. Coraline's favorite memory at St. Patrick's was going to treetops in grade 6. Coraline will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where she is going to try to succeed in being a chemist. In 10 years, Coraline wants to become a chemist and one day travel to Osaka, Japan, to see the wondrous place that has arcades and much more to see. She also wants to help out her family as much as possible. Evan Sarkis came to St. Pat's in grade 7. Evan's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he got to arm wrestle with staff. Evan will be attending high school at Cass, where he wants to learn more about computers. In 10 years, Evan would like to be a famous YouTuber and have his own successful YouTube channel, like his friend William Yeeman. He would like to have enough money to be living in his own place in Woodstock. It is my great honor to recognize Evan's hard work and persistence this evening. Evan has achieved an academic average of 80% or higher, which makes him a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. Congratulations, Evan.
Jaden Felitti has been at St. Patrick's since grade 5. Jaden's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he came to St. Pat's and met some amazing people. Jaden will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is hoping to find peace and happiness with every step and every breath he takes. In 10 years, he will be done with university and plans to be a real estate agent or a lawyer. Everett Forrest has been at St. Patrick's since kindergarten. His favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when they won the volleyball championship. Everett will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is hoping to learn and grow into a good, successful man. In 10 years, Everett will have graduated from Notre Dame University and will have become a successful athlete. Caitlin Gardner has been at St. Patrick's since the first day of kindergarten. Caitlin's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when she went to Boulder Mountain and did all the courses and went on the big zip line. Caitlin will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where she is hoping to learn to be more independent. In 10 years, Caitlin wants to be done with school, dreams of being an actress, and hopes to travel the world to make up for all the time she spent in quarantine. On behalf of the Catholic Women's League of Holy Trinity Parish, we are pleased to announce that Caitlin is the winner of the CWL essay competition. Caitlin wrote a well-crafted essay that examined the ways in which the power of the Holy Spirit and church teachings can help address challenging moral situations. Well done, Caitlin. Christopher Goss has been at St. Patrick's for all of elementary school. Chris's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he participated in Mr. Mack's annual Monopoly tournament. Chris will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is excited to grow as a person. In 10 years, Chris hopes to be done with college or university and living happily and comfortably. This year, Christopher achieved an academic average of 80% or higher, which makes him a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. Furthermore, Chris is being recognized this evening as a co-recipient of the Principal's Award of Excellence. The Principal's Award of Excellence is awarded to the student or students who achieve the highest overall academic average. Congratulations, Chris. Your hard work, determination, and dedication to academics have served you well, and will no doubt continue to bring good things in the future.
Lincoln Graham has been at St. Patrick's since SK. Lincoln's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is going on school trips. Lincoln will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is hoping to make honor roll. In 10 years, Lincoln is hoping to be a police officer. This year, Lincoln has achieved an academic average of 80% or higher, which makes him a member of the 2021 honor roll. Congratulations, Lincoln. Devante Guevara Barrett has been at St. Patrick's since grade 6. Devante's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is any and all school basketball games. Devante will be attending high school at Cass, where he is excited to learn and play basketball if the COVID situation gets better. In 10 years, Devante hopes to have the ability to travel and isn't completely set on a job or dreams in the future. In 10 years from graduating high school, he he hopes to be in a comfortable living situation with his family.
Jezreel Jinko has been at St. Patrick's since 2019. Jezreel's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is spending time with her friends, doing fun things together in class and at recess. Jezreel will be attending high school at St. Mary's Catholic High School, where she is excited to meet old friends that graduated before her and new people as well. In 10 years, Jezreel hopes to overcome challenges, gain independence, and get a job and earn money to buy things she wants and needs. This year, Jezreel achieved an academic average of 80% or greater, which makes her a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. Congratulations, Jezreel.
Aven Knapp started at St. Patrick's in JKSK and left St. Patrick's in grade 1. Aven came back to St. Patrick's in grade 4 and has been here ever since. Aven has many great memories at St. Patrick's. Aven will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is excited for new opportunities. In 10 years, Aven plans to be happy and successful. Andres Lagos has been at St. Patrick's since junior kindergarten. Andres' favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when they won the junior basketball championship at St. Mary's. Andres will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is hoping to get great grades and get on the honor roll. In 10 years, Andres is hoping to get a full college scholarship for baseball and play in the MLB. Andres has achieved an academic average of 80% or higher, which makes him a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. In addition to this, Andres is also being recognized as a co-recipient of this year's winner of the Christian Living Award. Andres demonstrates a strong commitment to his faith, evidenced at school and within our parish community. He demonstrates a sound understanding of religious concepts and a curiosity and interest in continually developing his faith. Congratulations, Andres. Christopher Lale has been at St. Patrick's since grade 5. Christopher's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he started to make new friends in grade 5. Christopher will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he's excited for what comes after high school. In 10 years, Christopher hopes to be successful in more school so he can get his dream job.
Phoenix McMahon has been at St. Patrick's since October 2020. Her favorite memory is playing jukeball in gym class. Phoenix will be attending St. Mary's in September, where she hopes to make friends and graduate. In 10 years, Phoenix will be happy to be done with school.
Keelan Murphy has been at St. Patrick's for all of elementary school. Keelan's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when they would have a big snow fort war in the winter. Keelan will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he's excited to meet new people from all around Oxford County. In 10 years, Keelan hopes to have a well-paying job. Ava Newton has been at St. Patrick's since she was in kindergarten. Ava's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when she met her best friends, Kaylee and Taylor. Ava will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where she is going to study hard to get good grades, and when she is finished, she is going to go to university for a nursing degree. In 10 years, she hopes to be a fully licensed registered nurse, having fun with friends, and having a happy life that consists of work, friends, and her animals. Ava has achieved an academic average of 80% or higher this year, which makes her a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. Way to go, Ava.
Gabby Orzechowski has been at St. Patrick's since grade 4. Gabby's favorite memory at St. Patrick's was the grade 6 field trip. Gabby will be attending high school at Cass, where she is planning on graduating and moving on to college. In 10 years, Gabby hopes to be done with school, have a good job, and a house. Her dream is to work as a paramedic or an orthodontist. Gabby has achieved an academic average of 80% or higher, which makes her a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. Congratulations, Gabby. Aaron Owusu-Mensah has been at St. Patrick's since the very beginning of grade 7. His favorite memory of St. Patrick's is when his team won the grade 7-8 volleyball tournament. Aaron will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is hoping to get into a great college or university. In 10 years, Aaron will graduate both college and university and will be working as an engineer or own his own business. After he becomes really successful, he will travel the world and live a happy life. This year, Aaron achieved an academic average of 80% or higher, which makes him a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. Congratulations, Aaron.
Carter Skevington has been at St. Patrick's from the first day of junior kindergarten till the last day of grade 8. Carter's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he won Monopoly in grade 6. Carter will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is hoping to get his high school diploma, is excited to join clubs, and is planning to get good grades. In 10 years, Carter hopes to have graduated from university and be finishing vet school. He also hopes to have started a family and have a nice house. Carter has achieved an academic average of 80% or higher this year, makes him a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. Congratulations, Carter.
Vienna Summers has been at St. Patrick's since February 2021. Vienna's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when she had a combined gym class with Mr. Martin's class. Vienna will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where she is excited to meet new people. In 10 years, Vienna wants to be a criminologist, and she plans to have graduated college or university. She also dreams of traveling the world.
Monte Thompson has been at St. Patrick's for all of his elementary school years, starting back in kindergarten. Monte's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is the grade 6 field trip to a forest obstacle course for the end of the year trip. Monte will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where he is going to prepare to go to college when done high school. In 10 years, Monte will have graduated college and gotten his dream job as a famous gaming YouTuber. Enoch Teppo has been at St. Patrick's since grade 5. Enoch's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he beat Mr. Mack in chess. It's his favorite memory because only two other students beat him, but Enoch beat him 2 times. Enoch will be attending high school at St. Mary's and is hoping to travel the world when finished. In 10 years, Enoch is planning to be in the NBA. Enoch plans to have graduated college or university and have a good job. He dreams of traveling. Lucas Edding has been at St. Patrick's since JK. Lucas's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when he got to go to Bowler Mountain. Lucas will be attending high school at Cass, where he will play football and finish and graduate grade 12. In 10 years, Lucas hopes to buy his own house. Kylie Van Weinsberg has been at St. Patrick's since grade 3. Kylie's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when it was winter in 8th grade and her class went sledding down a hill. Kylie will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where she is hoping to succeed and prepare for an art career. In 10 years, Kylie hopes to successfully start a job with art and sell the pieces to make money or work on her singing voice to hopefully become a successful singer. Lauren Warnock has been at St. Patrick's since junior kindergarten. Lauren's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when she was in Mr. Mack's class in grade 6 and she got to wear the GoPro at Treetops. Lauren will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where she is excited to hopefully make numerous sports teams like soccer, basketball, volleyball, and more. In 10 years, Lauren hopes to be joining the Army and then becoming a firefighter by attending Lambton College for the practices, or maybe even taking her basketball career to the next level. Dan Williams has been at St. Patrick's since grade 3. She moved here from Jamaica. Tessanne's favorite memory at St. Patrick's was her first day of school. Tessanne will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where she is planning to finish school and go to the military. In 10 years, Tessanne hopes to travel lots and help people at the same time. She would also like to get her dream ranking, O-10, in the military, but with hard work and dedication, she knows she can do it.
Lily Voitis has been at St. Patrick's since kindergarten. Lily's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when she went on a field trip to Bowler Mountain in Mr. McDonald's class. Lily will be attending high school at St. Mary's or St. Joseph's, where she is planning to attend academic classes to have a better chance of studying at university. In 10 years, Lily plans to graduate university to become a teacher at an elementary school. Lily is being recognized for multiple awards this evening. This year, Lily achieved an academic average of 80% or higher, which makes her a member of the 2021 Honor Roll. Lily is also the female recipient of the St. Patrick's Athletic Award, as well as a co-recipient of the Christian Living Award. Clearly, Lily is a highly motivated student athlete who has incorporated the gospel values into all aspects of her life. Well done, Lily.
Mm. Madison Young came to St. Pat's in senior kindergarten. Maddie's favorite memory at St. Patrick's is when her grade 6 class went to Bowler Mountain. Maddie will be attending high school at St. Mary's, where she is excited to meet new people. In 10 years, Maddie hopes to graduate college or university and have a good job that requires her to travel the world. Evening, Landon Chase has the honor of addressing St. Patrick's graduating class of 2021 with his valedictorian address.
Good evening, fellow graduates, staff, and families that are celebrating with me today. I wish to thank all you graduates who gave me the opportunity to represent the great graduating students of 2021. I also wish to thank the parents, guardians, principals, teachers, ECEs, EAs, and other staff that have aided us in growing and learning in the past years. I came to St. Patrick's in grade 2, and everyone pretty much had their friendships decided by kindergarten. But I was welcomed by everyone and made friends very quickly, and I thank all of you for that. St. Patrick's has always been a welcoming community, and it continues to be as I see new students always being welcomed regularly every year. We have reached a huge milestone in our lives, and even though we aren't celebrating as we had probably imagined, this day still has great meaning. Recent challenges we have all faced have bonded us. They've made us more resilient and capable of whatever the future throws our way. These challenges have had a great impact on shaping us. Imagine all of us are like puzzles that God perfectly formed so that every piece fits together. And then God pulls apart all the pieces and throws them down to a rock that's going to explode in about 4 billion years. But now that we are on Earth, we can start collecting our puzzle pieces. One when we learn to walk, one when we learn to talk, and one when we start school for the very first time. We have spent the first years of our lives collecting our puzzle pieces and slowly becoming what God wanted us to be. Today is another one of our pieces. We have worked so hard for this We have worked so hard to achieve this, and it will contribute to who we are forever. This doesn't mean we are done though. There'll be more challenges and much bigger milestones that we will all achieve in the future years. Everyone has the ability to do amazing things and change people's lives or even the entire world. But it all starts with you wanting to make that change to improve the world. There's so much potential in everyone, and it is up to us to choose if we will act on it. Anyone can choose to ignore those in need and take the easy path, but we can all stop that from happening to us and take the chance to help others and be a guide for the future generations. I hope to make a difference in all of your lives right now. Even though I'm not in person with all of you, I'm still able to send the same message. Whatever you all do with your lives, remember the glory and rewards do not matter. It's the change you make that will matter and make you feel accomplished. You must believe in yourself and what you have to say if you wish to meet your full potential. Now heading into high school, it'll be a lot harder to be who you are as those around you will try to change you. But everyone here can be who they are and what God intended them to be. There will be peer pressure, there will be struggles, friendships will be made and broken. However, there will also be great times ahead and new memories. There will also be new friends made and victories and accomplishments. It is now time for us to move on from St. Patrick's and continue to learn and discover our passions in high school. Many of us will be going to different schools and might not see each other again in a very long time, but we will always remember the school where we came from and where we started our journey. We will think back on the memories and friendships that were made here, which will bond us together forever and keep us close. Thank you to everyone who has taken the time to join me today, and I wish the best of luck to all of us starting the next chapter of our lives in high school. Also, can we all agree what a great disappointment it was that the annual gorge run was impossible this year? Let's just keep it in our memories, shall we? Thank you, and good night.
Thank you very much for this fitting address, Landon. Your words were at the same time deep and prophetic, clever and witty. exactly what we've come to expect from you over the years at St. Patrick's. Congratulations once again on this honor. At this time, I would like to introduce and welcome our principal, Mr. Stephen Todd, to say a few words to the graduating class.
Hi, everyone. My name is Stephen Todd, and I'm the principal for St. Patrick's. I would like to welcome you all here together to celebrate our graduating students in the class of 2021. While we may not all be together here in person today, I am glad that we can still find other ways to celebrate our graduates and recognize their hard work and dedication, both in education and Christ, as they prepare for the next phase in their lives. These past 2 years have been difficult. Students, staff, and families were looking forward to a return to normal, or as close as they could make it. However, some things are beyond our control, and we will need to wait a little bit longer before that returns to normal. In the meantime, I would like to share some advice with our graduates. We've heard so many things and so many times about what we're not allowed to do. But today, I'd like to share some things that you can do to help make your transition to high school a little bit better. First, embrace challenge. You are not in this alone. Making the move to high school is something that can be intimidating, but know that your friends and family are there for you. You will meet new teachers, maybe make new friends, maybe keep some of your old friends, but you will learn and grow together. You will have opportunities to join new clubs and sports. Try out new things you may not have had a chance to before, and push yourselves to the limit. If you don't take a chance, you may miss out on something that you can truly become passionate about. Don't feel like you have to have your life decided by the time you start grade 9, and don't feel like you have to have your life decided by the time you leave for grade 12. There's plenty of life and plenty of time to make those decisions. In the meantime, seek supports and be those supports for others. Don't be afraid to ask for help, and don't be afraid to offer help. Second, be kind and compassionate. Understand that many people go through many things, and if you're there for them, they'll be there for you. Friendship is hard work. The reward, however, is knowing you'll always have others there to look out for you, just as you'll look out for them. Don't be afraid to ask something or someone how you can help, and take the opportunity to go that extra step. In a time where we don't see our friends as often as we used to, these bonds become stronger and more important than ever. Most importantly, continue to serve Christ. Go that extra mile and take that extra step to help those in need. This is something I see each and every one of you follow every day. Don't stop. Find something that you're passionate about. Find something that will help us out, and follow the Lord's example. In closing, I want to wish each and every one of you your best wishes next year and beyond. Even though my time with you has been short, what your teachers have shared with me shows the pride that they take in being part of your lives and you being part of theirs. You have the world at your fingertips and the power to invoke inspiration and change. Take pride in your accomplishments. Thank you and best wishes.
It is with great pleasure that I'm now able to say, congratulations, graduates. On behalf of all your teachers and educational assistants this year, and all staff that have taught and supported you over the years, we want to thank you for the amazing people you are and the things you have done at St. Patrick's. This is a very special graduating class in so many ways. During a year filled with uncertainty and challenges resulting from pandemic closures and remote learning, you have consistently shown resilience, flexibility, and adaptability. We look forward to hearing many more great things about you in the years to come. Graduates, never forget your roots, and remember that you are forever Eagles and are always welcome to come back and visit or volunteer.
Félicitations les huitièmes.
Bonjour tout le monde. First and foremost, we would like to congratulate you on all the hard work that you've done this year.
You guys have done so awesome, especially through all the obstacles that we've had to face this year. And we are just so proud of you, and we are so excited for you guys to take the next step in your education. And rock high school. You're going to do great. Alors, bonne chance. What do you want to say?
Oui, bonne chance. And the last thing I would like to add is that we both hope that we can run into you at some point, maybe when you're all grown up and graduated high school, and we can have a full-on French conversation. So I do look forward to that.
That's right. And remember that high school is all about having fun, trying hard, making friends, and being kind. Okay, so I wish you all the best. We wish you all the best. And have a great rest of your life. From the French department.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
On behalf of the St. Patrick's staff and graduates, we would like to thank the following people. Lori Davey, for her contributions to make this graduating year memorable for our graduates and their families. Mrs. Davey organized grad photos and created a grad composite for each student. These composites will be provided to the students on behalf of St. Patrick's in their grad packages that will be received tomorrow. Mrs. Lagos and Mrs. Force, for their thoughtful generosity. Parent Council, for their contributions not only to our graduation, but also over the years for making our many experiences at St. Patrick's possible. Mr. Cochran and Mrs. Hurley, for sharing their technical expertise. Ms. Ambrosiak, for helping with printing and laminating. Mrs. Stanley, for all the work she does in so many areas supporting the students of St. Patrick's. The CWL at Holy Trinity, for the gifts they provided for our graduates and for conducting the essay writing contest earlier this year. And thank you to all St. Patrick's staff who have invested in this graduating class over the years and for their contributions to the graduation celebration this year. We cannot thank all of you enough.
Tomorrow, Wednesday, June 23rd, is the school drive-up portion of our graduation celebration. Please remember the designated time slot that has been assigned to your family. Mr. Todd has provided families with this information through School Messenger. Families are asked to arrive at least 10 to 15 minutes prior to the designated time slot. St. Patrick's staff will greet families at the parking lot by the baseball diamonds to provide specific instructions upon arrival. Please ensure your family is following current public health guidelines in regards to group sizes, physical distancing, and masking. A maximum of 6 guests are allowed to accompany each graduate, as Mr. Todd and the classroom teacher will be included in this group size of 10. Each graduate will receive a package containing all graduation documents and items, and time is provided for photos to be taken. Thank you for respecting the 10-minute time slot that has been assigned to your family. Timeliness will strictly be enforced to ensure our flow of the day continues for our entire graduating class. Thank you.
This concludes our virtual graduation celebration. Congratulations once again to all the graduates and their families. We wish you all the best in your future endeavors, and we look forward to seeing you all tomorrow at our drive-up celebration. Thank you all, and good night.
May you have auspiciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in your being generous, sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. Whoa. May the road less paved be the road that you follow.